This channel has been established for visually impaired people. For the visually impaired people, voice narration and a written expression are also provided for the hearing impaired. Don't forget to subscribe to our channel. The Bangladesh Awami League Bengali transliteration, Bangladesh Awami Liga translated from Urdu, Bangladesh People's League, AL is one of the two major political parties of Bangladesh. It is the country's current governing party, after winning a majority in heavily criticized 2014 parliamentary elections where the majority of seats were uncontested. The All Pakistan Awami Muslim League was founded in Dhaka, the capital of the then Pakistani province of East Bengal, in 1949 by Bengali nationalists Maulana Abdul Hamid Khan Bashani, Shaukat Ali, Yar Muhammad Khan, Shamsul Huq, and later Hussein Shahid Sohrawardi, who went on to become Prime Minister of Pakistan. The Pakistan Awami Muslim League was established as the Bengali alternative to the domination of the Muslim League in Pakistan and over centralization of the government. The party quickly gained massive popular support in East Bengal, later named East Pakistan, and eventually led the forces of Bengali nationalism in the struggle against West Pakistan's military and political establishment. The party, under the leadership of Sheikh Mujibur Rahman, the founding father of Bangladesh, would lead the struggle for independence, first through massive populist and civil disobedience movements, such as the Six-Point Movement and 1971 Non-Cooperation Movement, and then during the Bangladesh Liberation War. After the emergence of independent Bangladesh, the Awami League would win the first general elections in 1973 but was overthrown in 1975 after the assassination of Sheikh Mujibur Rahman. The party was forced by subsequent military regimes into political sidelines, and many of its senior leaders and activists were executed and jailed after the restoration of democracy in 1990. The Awami League emerged as one of the principal players of Bangladeshi politics. Amongst the leaders of the Awami League, 5 have become the President of Bangladesh, 4 have become the Prime Minister of Bangladesh, and 1 became the Prime Minister of Pakistan. The incumbent Prime Minister of Bangladesh, Sheikh Hasina, has been heading the party since 1981. The student wing of the party is the Bangladesh Chhatra League. Contents 1 History 11 Founding and Early Pakistan Era 1949-66-12 Struggle for Independence and Mujib Era 1966-75-13 Struggle for Democracy and Hasina Era 1981 Present 2 Name and Symbols 3 Ideology 4 Organization 41 Constitution 42 National Conference 43 Central Working Committee 44 Advisory Council 45 Wings 5 Leader of the AL, 1949 Present 6 Head of State from AL 61 President of Bangladesh 62 Vice President of Bangladesh 7 Head of Government from AL 71 Prime Minister of Pakistan 72 Chief Minister of East Pakistan 73 Prime Minister of Bangladesh 8 Election Results 81 Parliament of Pakistan 82 Provincial Assembly of East Pakistan 83 Parliament of Bangladesh 9 See also 10 references. 11 External links. History Founding and Early Pakistan Era 1949-66 Rose Garden Palace, birthplace of the Awami League in 1949. On 14 August 1947, the partition of India saw the establishment of the Muslim state of Pakistan on the basis of the two-nation theory. The new country comprised two wings, separated by 1,000 miles of Indian territory. In the Indian subcontinent, the western wing consisted of the provinces of Punjab, Sindh, Northwest Frontier Province and Balochistan, while the province of East Bengal constituted the eastern wing. From the onset of independence, Pakistan was led by its founder Muhammad Ali Jinnah and his Muslim League Party. In 1948, there was rising agitation in East Bengal against the omission of Bengali script from coins, stamps and government exams. Thousands of students, mainly from the University of Dhaka, protested in Dhaka and clashed with security forces. Prominent student leaders including Shamsul Huq, Khaliq Nawaz Khan, Shaukat Ali, Qazi Ghulam Mahbub, Ali Ahad, Sheikh Mujibur Rahman and Abdul Wahed were arrested, and the police were accused of excessive brutality while charging protesters in March. Senior Bengali political leaders were attacked whilst leading protests demanding that Bengali be declared an official language in Pakistan. The leaders included the AK Fazlul Huq, the former Prime Minister of Undivided Bengal amidst the rising Discontent in East Bengal, Jinnah visited Dhaka and announced that Urdu would be sole state language of Pakistan given its significance to Islamic nationalism in South Asia. Full citation needed. The announcement caused uproar in East Bengal, where the native Bengali population resented Jinnah for his attempts to impose a language they hardly understood. The resentment was further fueled by rising discrimination against Bengalis in government, industry, bureaucracy and the armed forces and the dominance of the Muslim League. The Bengalis argued that they constituted the ethnic majority of Pakistan's population and Urdu was remote to the land of Bengal, located in the eastern Indian subcontinent. Moreover, the rich literary heritage of the Bengali language and the deep-rooted secular culture of Bengali society led to a strong sense of linguistic and cultural nationalism amongst the people of East Bengal. The only language in Pakistan not written in the Persian Arabic script was Bengali. Against this backdrop, Bengali nationalism began to take root within the Muslim League and the party's Bengali members began to rebel. On 23 June 1949, Bengali nationalists from East Bengal broke away from the Muslim League, Pakistan's dominant political party, and established the All Pakistan Awami Muslim League. The party was founded at the Rose Garden Mansion in the old part of Dhaka. Maulana Abdul Hamid Khan Bhashani and Shamsul Huq were elected the first president and general secretary of the party respectively. Ator Rahman Khan was elected the vice president while Sheikh Mujibur Rahman Khandakar Mostak Ahmad and A.K. Rafiqul Hussain were elected the party's first joint secretaries. The party was formed to champion the rights of masses in Pakistan against the powerful feudal establishment led by the Muslim League. However, due to its strength stemming from the discriminated Bengali population of Pakistan's Eastern Wing, the party eventually became associated and identified with East Bengal in 1952. The Awami Muslim League and its student wing played an instrumental role in the Bengali language movement, during which Pakistani security forces fired upon thousands of protesting students demanding Bengali be declared an official language of Pakistan and famously killing a number of students including Abdus Salam, Rafiq Adin Ahmed, Abul Barkat and Abdul Jabbar. The events of 1952 are widely seen by historians today as a turning point in the history of Pakistan and the Bengali people, as it was the starting point of the Bengali nationalist struggle that eventually culminated in the creation of Bangladesh in 1971. In 1953, the party's council meeting voted to drop the word Muslim from its name in order to give it a more secular outlook, owing to need of including the province's large Hindu population in Pakistani politics. In the run-up to the East Bengal Legislative Assembly elections in 1954, the Awami League took the lead in negotiations in forming a pan-Bengali political alliance including the Krishak Praja Party, Nizam-e-Islam and Ganatantrik Dal. The alliance was termed the Jukta Front or United Front and formulated the Ekush Dafa, or 21-point charter, to fight the Muslim League. The party also took the historic decision to adopt the traditional Bengali boat, which signified the attachment to rural Bengal, as its election symbol. The election swept the United Front coalition into power in East Bengal with a massive mandate of 223 seats out of 237 seats. The Awami League itself won 143 seats, while the Muslim League won only 9 seats. Veteran student leader and language movement stalwart Khalik Nawaz Khan defeated incumbent Prime Minister of the then East Bengal Mr. Nurul Amin in a landslide margin. Mr. Nurul Amin was defeated in his home Nandel constituency. Khalik Nawaz Khan created history at age 27 by defeating sitting Prime Minister, and Muslim League was wiped out from political landscape of the then East Pakistan. A.K. Fazlul Huq assumed the office of Chief Minister of East Bengal and drew up a cabinet containing many of the prominent student activists that were leading movements against the Pakistani state. They included Sheikh Mujibur Rahman from the Awami League, who served as Commerce Minister. Leaders of the new provincial government demanded greater provincial autonomy for East Bengal and eventually succeeded in pressuring Prime Minister Muhammad Ali Bogra, himself a Bengali, to endorse the proposed constitutional recognition of Bengali as an official language of Pakistan. The United Front also passed a landmark order for the establishment of the Bangla Academy in Dhaka as tensions with the Western Wing grew due to the demands for greater provincial autonomy in East Bengal. Governor General Ghulam Muhammad dismissed the United Front government on 29 May 1954 under Article 92 of the Provisional Constitution of Pakistan. In September 1956, the Awami League formed a coalition with the Republican Party to secure a majority in the new National Assembly of Pakistan and took over the central government. Awami League President Hussain Shaheed Sohrawardi became the Prime Minister of Pakistan. Sohrawardi pursued a reform agenda Canada to reduce the long-standing economic disparity between East and West Pakistan, greater representation of Bengalis in the Pakistani civil and armed services, and he unsuccessfully attempted to alleviate the food shortage in the country. The Awami League also began deepening relations with the United States. The government moved to join the Southeast Asia Treaty Organization CETO and Central Treaty Organization CENTO, the two strategic defense alliances in Asia inspired by the North Atlantic Treaty Organization NATO. Maulana Bashani, one of the party's founders, condemned the decision of the Surawardi government and called a conference in February 1957 at Kagmari in East Bengal. He protested the move and the support lent by the Awami League leadership to the government. Bashani broke away from the Awami League and then formed the leftist National Awami Party NAP. The controversy over one unit, the division of Pakistan into only two provinces, East and West, and the appropriate electoral system for Pakistan, whether joint or separate, also revived. As soon as Surawardi became Prime Minister in West Pakistan, there was strong opposition to the joint electorate by the Muslim League and the religious parties. The Awami League, however, strongly supported the joint electorate. These differences over one unit and the appropriate electorate caused problems for the government. By early 1957, the movement for the dismemberment of the one unit had started. Surawardi was at the mercy of central bureaucracy fighting to save the one unit. Many in the business elite in Karachi were lobbying against Surawardi's decision to distribute millions of dollars of American aid to East Pakistan and to set up a national shipping corporation. Supported by these lobbyists, President Iskander Mirza demanded the Prime Minister's resignation. Surawardi requested to seek a vote of confidence in the National Assembly, but this request was turned down. Surawardi resigned under threat of dismissal on 10 October 1957. On 7 October 1958, President Iskander Mirza declared martial law and appointed Army Chief General Ayub Khan as Chief Martial Law Administrator. Ayub Khan eventually deposed Mirza in a bloodless coup by promulgating the political party's elected body's disqualified ordinance. Ayub banned all major political parties in Pakistan. Senior politicians, including the entire top leadership of the Awami League, were arrested and most were kept under detention till 1963. In 1962, Ayub Khan drafted a new constitution, modeled on indirect election, through an Electoral College, and termed it basic democracy. Hussein Shaheed Surawardi joined Nurul Amin, Khwaja Nazimuddin, Maulvi Farid Ahmed and Hamidul Haq Chowdhury in forming National Democratic Front against Ayub Khan's military-backed rule and to restore elective democracy. However, the alliance failed to obtain any concessions. Instead, the Electoral Colleges appointed a new parliament and the president exercised executive authority. Widespread discrimination prevailed in Pakistan against Bengalis during the regime of Ayub Khan. The University of Dhaka became a hotbed for student activism advocating greater rights for Bengalis and the restoration of democracy in Pakistan. On 5 December 1963, Hussein Shaheed Surawardi was found dead in his hotel room in Beirut, Lebanon. His sudden death under mysterious circumstances gave rise to speculation within the Awami League and the general population in East Pakistan that he had been poisoned. Struggle for independence and Mujib era 1966-75. Sheikh Mujibur Rahman and Awami League members campaigning in East Pakistan before the 1970 general election. The 6-point demands, proposed by Mujib, were widely accepted by the East Pakistani populace, as they proposed greater autonomy for the provinces of Pakistan after the so-called Agartala conspiracy case, and subsequent end of the Ayub Khan's regime in Pakistan. The Awami League and its leader Sheikh Mujib reached the peak of their popularity among the East Pakistani Bengali population in the elections of 1970. The Awami League won 167 of 169 East Pakistan seats in the National Assembly, but none of West Pakistan's 138 seats. It also won 288 of the 300 provincial assembly seats in East Pakistan. This win gave the Awami League a healthy majority in the 313-seat National Assembly and placed it in a position to establish a national government without a coalition partner. This was not acceptable to the political leaders of West Pakistan, who feared the 6 points were a step towards breaking up the country and led directly to the events of the Bangladesh Liberation War. A particular point of disagreement was transferring 6 powers to one province, which was unprecedented. The Awami League leaders, taking refuge in India, successfully led the war against the Pakistani army throughout 1971. Leader Sheikh Mujib was arrested by the Pakistan army on 25 March 1971, but the Bangladeshi people continued the fight to free themselves. For 9 months after victory on 16 December 1971, the party formed the National Government of Bangladesh. In 1972, under Sheikh Mujib, the party name was changed to Awami League. The new government faced many challenges as they rebuilt the country and carried out mine clearing operations. The party had newspaper editors arrested and shut down the nation's newspapers, leaving only four in operation. Food shortages were also a major concern of the Awami League. War had damaged all forms of farming. The party aligned itself with NAM and leaned towards the Soviet bloc. The party was accused of corruption by supporters of Pakistan. In 1974, Bangladesh suffered a famine. 70,000 people died, and support for Mujib declined. Bangladesh continued exporting jute to Cuba, violating U.S. economic sanctions. The Nixon government barred grain imports to Bangladesh. This exacerbated famine conditions. Main article: Bangladesh Krishak Shramik Awami League. In January 1975, facing violent leftist insurgents, Mujib declared a state of emergency and later assumed the presidency. After the Awami League-dominated parliament decided to switch from parliamentary to a presidential form of government, Sheikh Mujib renamed the league the Bangladesh Krishak Shramik Awami League, and banned all other parties. The consequences lead to a critical political state. Baksal was dissolved after the assassination of Sheikh Mujibur Rahman. The move towards a secular form of government caused widespread dissatisfaction among many low-ranking military personnel, most of whom received training from Pakistan Army. On 15 August 1975, during the time of Major Zior Rahman as a head of the army staffs, some junior members of the armed forces in Dhaka, led by Major Farooq Rahman and Major Rashid, murdered Sheikh Mujibur Rahman and all his family members, including his wife and minor son, within months. On 3 November 1975, four more of its top leaders, Syed Nazrul Islam, Tajuddin Ahmed, Captain Muhammad Mansur Ali and Ahm Kamaruzaman, were killed inside the Dhaka Central Jail as they were on behalf of Baksal only. Sheikh Hasina and Sheikh Rahana, two daughters of Mujib, survived. The massacre, as they were in West Germany as a part of a cultural exchange program. They later claimed political asylum in the United Kingdom. Sheikh Rahana, the younger sister, chose to remain in the UK permanently, while Sheikh Hasina moved to India and lived in self-imposed exile. Her stays abroad helped her gain important political friends in the West and in India that proved to be a valuable asset for the party in the future struggle for democracy and Hasina era. 1981-present. Sheikh Hasina lead the Awami League mass rally of Dhaka blockade, to demand an end to the rule of President Hussein Mohammad Ershad based on violations of democracy. November 10, 1987. After 1975, the party remained split into several rival factions, and fared poorly in the 1979 parliamentary elections held under a military government. In 1981, Sheikh Hasina returned after the largest party faction, the Awami League, elected her its president, and she proceeded to take over the party leadership and unite the factions. As she was under age at the time, she could not take part in the 1981 presidential elections that followed the assassination of then-President Zior Rahman. Throughout the following 9 years of military rule by General Hossein Mohammad Ershad, the Awami League participated in some polls but boycotted most, as Ershad did not believe in democracy. The Awami League emerged as the largest opposition party in parliament in the elections in 1991, in which Begum Khalida Zia became the first female prime minister. AL's second term in office had mixed achievements. Apart from sustaining economic stability during the Asian economic crisis, the government successfully settled Bangladesh's long-standing dispute with India over sharing the water of the River Ganges, also known as Padma, in late 1996, and signed a peace treaty with tribal rebels in 1997. In 1998, Bangladesh faced one of the worst floods ever, and the government handled the crisis satisfactorily. It also had significant achievements in containing inflation, and peacefully neutralizing a long-running leftist insurgency in southwestern districts dating back to the first AL government's time. However, rampant corruption allegations against party office bearers and ministers, as well as a deteriorating law and order situation, troubled the government. Its pro-poor policies achieved wide microeconomic development, but that left the country's wealthy business class dissatisfied. The AL's last months in office were marred by sporadic bombing by alleged Islamist militants. Hasina herself escaped several attempts on her life, in one of which two anti-tank mines were planted under her helipad in Gopalganj district in July 2001. The second AL government stepped down, becoming the first elected government in Bangladesh to serve a full term in office. The party won only 62 out of 300 parliamentary seats in the elections held in October 2001, despite winning 40% of the votes, up from 36% in 1996 and 33% in 1991. The BNP and its allies won a two-thirds majority in parliament with 46% of the votes cast, with BNP alone winning 41%, up from 33% in 1996 and 30% in 1991. In its second term in opposition since 1991, the party suffered the assassination of several key members. Popular young leader Asanullah Master, a member of parliament from Ghazipur, was killed in 2004. This was followed by a grenade attack on Hasina during a public meeting on 21 August 2004, resulting in the death of 22 party supporters, including party women's secretary Ivy Rahman. Though Hasina lived finally, the party's electoral secretary, ex-finance minister, and veteran diplomat Shah M.S. Kabria, a member of parliament from Habiganj, was killed in a grenade attack in Sylhet later that year in June 2005. The Awami League won an important victory when the AL-nominated incumbent mayor ABM Mohiuddin Chowdhury won the important mayoral election in Chittagong, by a huge margin, against BNP nominee State Minister of Aviation Mir Muhammad Nasiruddin. This election was seen as a showdown between the Awami League and the BNP. However, the killing of party leaders continued in December 2005. The AL-supported mayor of Sylhet narrowly escaped the third attempt on his life as a grenade thrown at him failed to explode in September 2006. Several of the party's top leaders, including Sabir Hossain Chowdhury MP and Asaduzzaman Noor MP, were hospitalized after being critically injured by police beatings while they demonstrated in support of electoral law reforms starting in late October 2006. The Awami League-led alliance carried out a series of nationwide demonstrations and blockades centering on the election of the leader of the interim caretaker administration to oversee the 2007 elections. Although an election was scheduled to take place on the 22nd of January 2007 that the Awami League decided to boycott, the country's military intervened on the 11th of January 2007 and installed an interim government composed of retired bureaucrats and military officers throughout 2007 and 2008. The military-backed government tried to root out corruption and remove Sheikh Hasina and Khalida Zia of the AL and BNP respectively. While these efforts largely failed, they succeeded in producing a credible voter list that was used in the 29th of December 2008 national election. The Awami League won national election on the 29th of December 2008 as part of a larger electoral alliance that also included the Jatiya Party led by former military ruler General Hussein Muhammad Irshad as well as some leftist parties. According to the official results, Bangladesh Awami League won 230 out of 299 constituencies, and together with its allies, had a total of 262 parliamentary seats. The Awami League and its allies received 57% of the total votes cast. The AL alone got 48%, compared to 36% of the other major alliance led by the BNP, which by itself got 33% of the votes. Sheikh Hasina, as party head, is the new prime minister. Her term of office began in January 2009. The current cabinet has several new faces, including three women in prominent positions: Dr. Dipu Moni, foreign minister; Mattia Chowdhury, agriculture minister; and Sahara Cotton, home minister. Younger MPs with a link to assassinated members of the 1972-1975 AL government are Syed Ashraful Islam, son of Syed Nasrul Islam, Sheikh Tapish, son of Sheikh Fazlul Huq Moni, and Sohail Taj, son of Tajuddin Ahmad. Since 2009, the Awami League government faced several major political challenges, including BDR Bangladesh Rifles mutiny, power crisis, unrest in garments industry and stock market fluctuations. Judicial achievements for the party included restoring original 1972 constitution, returning secularism to the constitution, beginning of war crimes trials, and guilty verdict in 1975 assassination trial. According to the Nielsen two-year survey, 50% felt the country was moving in the right direction, and 36% gave the government a favorable rating in 2014 election. The Awami League-led alliance won the second term in July 2016. A Buddhist leader of the political party was assassinated by ISIS. Name and symbols. The first flag of the Awami League used during the Pakistani period, the All Pakistan Awami Muslim League Urdu, All Pakistan Awami MSLM League, or the East Pakistan Awami Muslim League was formed as a breakaway faction of the All Pakistan Muslim League in 1949. Within 2 years of the formation of Pakistan, the word Muslim was dropped in 1953 and it became the Secular Awami League during the Bangladesh Liberation War of 1971. Most of the Awami League members joined the Provisional Government of Bangladesh and Mukti Bahini guerrillas to fight against the Pakistani army and the name Bangladesh Awami League was eventually settled upon. The most common mascot and electoral symbol for the party has been the boat, which signified the attachment to rural Bengal. Traditionally, the party had no consistent color identity after the 1991 election. The color green became associated with Awami League, while blue has become the identifying color for rival nationalist party. The salutation Joy Bangla Bengali, Jaya Banla, meaning victory to Bengal or Long Live Bengal, is the official slogan of the Awami League. It was the slogan and war cry of the Mukti Bahini that fought for the independence of Bangladesh during the Bangladesh Liberation War in 1971. The phrase Joy Bangla, Joy Bangabandhu, is used by the party members at the end of speeches and communications pertaining to or referring to patriotism towards Bangladesh and Bangabandhu Sheikh Mujib. The Awami League party flag is a green field with 4-5 rayed red star at its center, and a vertical red stripe at the hoist side. The flag also bears some resemblance to the flag of Pakistan, showing the ex-Pakistani origin of the Awami League. The four stars on the flag represent the four fundamental principles of the party: nationalism, secularism, socialism, and democracy ideology. The Bangladesh Awami League styles itself as the leader of the pro-liberation forces in Bangladesh, promoting secular and social democratic sections of the political establishment in the country. The party constitution states, and in two cases defines the reason for, four fundamental principles in guiding its philosophy and policies. They include democracy, socialism, secularism, nationalism. Before the 2008 general elections in Bangladesh, the Awami League announced in its manifesto, its Vision 2021 and Digital Bangladesh action plans to transform Bangladesh into a fast-developing middle-income country by 2021. The party uses the term Shonar Bangla, or Golden Bengal, to describe its vision for Bangladesh to become a modern developed nation. The term is reminiscent of Bangladesh's national anthem and a utopian vision in Bengali nationalism. Organization Constitution. The constitution of the Bangladesh Awami League Bengali, Bangladesa Awami Liga Era Gathanatantra. Bangladesa Awami League Era Gathanatantra has 24 articles and includes contents of general program, membership, organization system, central organizations, name, aims and objectives, fundamental principles, commitments in accordance with the changing situation and tasks. Revisions were made in some of the articles at the National Conference. National Conference. The National Conference NC Bengali, Jatiya Sammelana. Jatiya Sammelana is the party's highest body, and, since the first National Conference in 1949, has been convened every 3 years, sometimes on an irregular basis according to the party's constitution. The National Conference may be postponed on except under extraordinary circumstances. The party constitution gives the NC following responsibilities: electing the president, electing the general secretary, examining the report of the outgoing central working committee, discussing and enacting party policies, revising the party's constitution. In practice, the party councillors and delegates rarely discuss issues at length at the national conference. Most substantive discussion takes place before the conference, in the preparation period, among a group of top party leaders. In between national conferences, the central working committee is the highest decision-making institution. Central Working Committee. The Central Working Committee Bengali, Kendriya Karyanirbahi Sansada. Kendriya Karyanirbahi Sansada of the Awami League is a political body that comprises the top leaders of the party. It is currently composed of 81 full members and 29 alternate members. Members are elected once every 3 years by the National Conference of the Bangladesh Awami League. The Central Working Committee is made up of the following: the party presidium, the party president, 17 presidium members, the general secretary, 4 joint general secretary, the treasurer, 28 additional members, 29 secretaries of the subcommittee, finance and planning secretary, international affairs secretary, law affairs secretary, agriculture and cooperation secretary, information and research secretary, relief and social welfare secretary, office secretary, religious affairs secretary, press and publications secretary, forest and environment secretary, science and technology affairs secretary, women affairs secretary, liberation war affairs secretary, youth and sports affairs secretary, education and human resource secretary, industries and commerce secretary, labor and manpower secretary, cultural affairs secretary, health and population Secretary 8 Organizing Secretary Deputy Office Secretary Deputy Press Secretary and 10 Parliamentary Committee Member Advisory Council Almost 38 Advisory Council Bengali, Upadesta Parisada Members working as parties think tank and are not part of the Central Working Committee Wings Bangladesh Awami Youth League Youth Wing Bangladesh Students League Students Wing Bangladesh Krishak League Farmers Wing Jaisho Shromik League Trade Union Wing Bangladesh Awami Swechespak League Volunteers Wing Bangladesh Mohila Awami League Women Wing Awami Angibi Porisad Lawyers Wing Bangladesh Tati League Weavers Wing Swadhanata Chikitsak Parishad SWACHIP Physicians Wing Leader of the AL, 1949 present. President-elected National Conference, NC in office term length General Secretary Abdul Hamid Khan Bishani NC, 1949, 53, 55 the 23rd of June 1949 to the 27th of July 1956 7008-2238408000000 Spade Suit 7. NC 1957 64 the 10th of October 1957 to the 25th of January 1966 7008261705600000000 Spade Suit 8 the 4th of April 1977 to the 16th of February 1978 7007274752000000000 Spade Suit 318 Head of State from AL President of Bangladesh Named Term in Office Sheikh Mujibur Rahman 1971-1972 Abu Sayyid Chowdhury 1972-1973 Muhammad Mohammadullah 1974-1975 Sheikh Mujibur Rahman 1975 Assassinated Kandakar Mostak Ahmad 1975 Deposed Abu Sadat Muhammad Sayyam 1975-1977 Zillur Rahman 2009-2013 Died in Office Abdul Hamid 2013 Present Vice President of Bangladesh Named Term in Office Note Syed Nazrul Islam 1971-1972 Acting President during the Bangladesh Liberation War Head of Government from AL Prime Minister of Pakistan Named Term in Office Hussein Shahid Surawardi 1956-1957 Chief Minister of East Pakistan Named Term in Office Ator Rahman Khan 1956-1958 Prime Minister of Bangladesh Named Term in Office Tajuddin Ahmad 1971-1972 Sheikh Mujibur Rahman 1972-1975 Muhammad Mansur Ali 1975 Sheikh Hasina 1996-2001, 2009 Present Election Results Parliament of Pakistan Election Year Hash of Constituency Votes Hash of overall seats won GOVT Note 1970 12,937,162 732% 288/300 No is blocked from governing by the West Pakistan Parliament of Bangladesh Election Year Hash of Constituency Votes Overall seats won, GOVT 1973 13,798,717 732% 34% 293/300 Yes 1979 4,734,277 245% 4,875% 39/300 145 No 1986 7,462,157 262% 23% 76/300 37 No 1991 10,259,866 301% 39% 88/300 12 No 1996 15,882,792 374% 73% 146/300 58 Yes 2001 22,310,276 4,002% 262% 62/300 84 No 2008 33,887,451 490% 89% 233,168 Yes 2014 36,173,883 7914% 3014% 234 300s 4 Yes. See also Politics of Bangladesh, List of political parties in Bangladesh, Bangladesh Nationalist Party, List of political parties in Pakistan, National Awami Party, Awami National Party. References. Carrot Berry, Ellen, 6 January 2014, Bangladesh's Governing Party Wins Vote Amid Unrest. The New York Times. 2012. Carat ABCDEFGH Hussain, Amid, 31 July 2009, Promises to Keep, Star Weekend Magazine, The Daily Star. 2005. Carat, U.S. Offers to Help Bangladesh Pursue War Crimes Trial, BBC News, 13 January 2011.